Hello, today we're going to be installing Visual Studio Code and we're going to be doing a C# console application. Now, as an introduction, we're going to be learning basically Hello World. This is getting it installed and getting you started up and running. VS Code is a little bit tricky at first. It's actually harder to work with than the regular Visual Studio, but it's free and open source. So let's go ahead and take a look at it. Okay, I'm not going to go into huge depth in what we're doing here, but we're going to be installing Visual Studio Code, which is a development platform for open source. We're also going to be installing Dotnet Core, which the code uses as the framework. Not going to talk a lot about why you use the framework, but I'll go really quickly over this little diagram. Dotnet Framework on the green little green side here is their huge framework for huge applications, and it's on my Windows computer, and it's used in big applications. .NET Core, it's only for Microsoft. .NET Core in the middle here is cross-platform. That means you can use it on Linux, Mac, and Windows, and I think it's a little more lightweight. This Xamarin on the right is for phones, iOS, and Android devices, not using that. Okay? So, you might ask, why use Visual Studio Code? That was the first thing I asked. Well, in one case, you may not want to buy Visual Studio, which is an expensive program that using corporations to build like app ASP apps, like .NET apps, like console applications, and big websites and things like that. It's full, huge featured. It's Microsoft's big studio, so you can develop things. Okay, well, this is more lightweight, more extensible. It's a little bit trickier to use, but it's a really good learning tool. So once I saw that was free and open source and it was used on different platforms, I thought that's really interesting. So that's why we're going to use Visual Studio Code. We're going to learn with it, and it's free and it's cross-platform if you want to use Linux with it and so on. So enough of that. So the first thing we need to do is go to Google or whatever search engine. I'm going to type in download .NET Core, Visual Studio Code. Download Visual Studio Code. Okay, should be the top one here. I've got Windows, I'm doing Windows 10, and we're going to do a C# Hello World application. So then I click download, and there it is, and it's going to my downloads. Shouldn't take very long. All right, we also need a framework. A framework is something that an application uses to get all the libraries and includes and references and stuff. Not going to talk a whole lot about that, but let's find that also. I'm going to go to Google. Let's download both of these things. You're installing two things. .NET Core SDK. It's important that you say the SDK because you might get the wrong thing. I got the wrong thing once and it caused me a lot of problems. So make sure you're getting the .NET Core 1.03 SDK installer. I have an x64 computer. I'm clicking on it. There's a problem with it, so I probably already have it in my downloads. Anyway, save file. Okay, now I'm saving it. It's downloading. It's only going to take me, I've got fast internet, like 10 seconds. So we've downloaded Visual Studio Code and .NET Core installer. I can go ahead and close the browser. Now, in my downloads, I have my Visual Studio Code set up. I'm going to go ahead and install that. Very simple. Easy install. You can read, you can use the defaults. That's what I'm going to do. It's just going to install it and create a shortcut. Very simple. Okay, now that we've downloaded Visual Studio Code, let's go ahead and install it. Let's go ahead and run it. There's my desktop. We're going to run. Okay. Well, before we do this, let's go to the desktop and create a new folder. This will be our Hello World project. Hello, I'm going to create a new folder on my desktop. Hello World. All right. Now let's take a look at Visual Studio Code. It looks a little strange, and it will take a little getting used to, but it will start to come to you after you use it. What you have is, this is a file right here, untitled. That's your start file. We don't need that. Here's some shortcuts and commands. These little icons are what you'll be using most, and we're going to use the File Explorer, and I'm going to open a folder that I just created on my desktop, Hello World, select the folder. It does like this refresh, and now you can see that we're actually, the File Explorer is over here, and you're in the my folder, Hello World. You can add a file and remove files and view files from here. All right, we're not going to look at this icon or this icon, but we will be looking at this icon, which is the debugger. When you have a program and you put a breakpoint, you can debug it. And very important, extensions. So if you click on extensions, I've already got these installed here, see? So what you're going to need to do is ignore what I'm doing right now. Since I already had it installed, I'm going to go ahead and uninstall it and reinstall it for you so you can see. So what you'll do, I already have Python, all these extensions. You're going to type in C Sharp. And the very first one that comes up is a C Sharp for Visual Studio Code. Install. Click on Install. Now Reload is like a refresh. It basically closes and starts your window. It needs to do that. That's fine. Now you should have C Sharp for Visual Studio Code extension installed. Now here's the power of this thing. If you notice, I've got Python, Python Extended, Python for VS Code. Not going to worry about that right now. But we do have C Sharp now. So we've got C Sharp and we're Hello World. Let's close this now. And remember, we still have to install our SDK core. So I'm going back to my downloads. I'm going to install, agree to everything. Very quick install. Okay. So we're all good. So now I've installed VS Code and .NET Core. I'm going to go ahead and open Visual Studio Code again. Okay, so we have an empty Hello World file folder. I'm going to hit a command that will bring up the command prompt within Visual Studio Code. And the command is control tilde. The tilde is this little squiggly mark that you see in Spanish words that is next to the one. And that's just a shortcut to open up the terminal window. Notice that it's in my desktop Hello World Explorer folder because we set that earlier. Next, you're going to type .NET new, and that's what it looks like, .NET new, and you'll hit enter, and it's going to create some files for you in that folder. We don't need to worry about what they are yet, but it's going to get you started, basically. .NET new means new project. Now, every time you make a change to your project, you're going to need to kind of compile it, and it will fix some links and things for you. So let's do this. .NET restore, and that looks like this. .NET restore, and that's going to fix all the links, and it's going to rebuild your project for you. And we can just sit here and watch it, and everything's good. Now we have some files to work with. This is equivalent to in Visual Studio going File, New Project, console application, and it's going to build some files for you. Well, that's what we just did. Not a big deal. We just did it from the command prompt. Okay. Program.cs is your main program, and it has a main startup function. And notice when I clicked on this file, it started downloading, but I got an error. This is sometimes it can be a little tricky. So we got an error, and it's notice that it's asking me up here, an error occurred in the .NET Core debugger. The extension may need to be reinstalled. Okay, so let's know that there's maybe a little error, and these things are going to happen. This is where, as you're learning, you're going to have to figure things out. I'm going to go ahead and hit F5 and run it and see what happens. Run download.NET Core Debugger in the command palette. So I had a problem with my extension because I've been installing and installing for this video. So I had to uninstall it, close down, and reinstall it, and now I'm working. So if you hit F5, that should build. See down here in the debug console, hello world. So this program calls main console.writeline hello world. Now if we wanted to add something else, hey Bugsy, don't forget your semicolon. Now one way you could do it is, remember, control tilde, then we could do a .NET. This is one way, there's other ways. .NET restore, that will rebuild it now that we made a change. Now let's go over here to this debug button. Suppose we put a breakpoint right there. It's going to stop on that line, or it should anyway. Now I hit the debug, and you have up here in this drop down, you should have a .NET Core launch console. This is a console application. It means it's very simple with a breakpoint. So if I hit the start button, it should run and stop. And notice that it stopped with this line here on hello world. If I hit F10, it'll step one line, hello world. Hello, hey Bugsy, and I can step and finish the program. Down here we have hello world. So the point of this video was to get you from nothing to hello world, and that's where I'm going to end this, but I will be adding more. Please make a comment below if you want a different type of tutorial, or if you have a problem with this, and I'll do my best to help you. This is a tricky application. There's lots of configurations and all. This is just the beginning. This is just the tip of the iceberg, but I hope this helped you get started, and let me know what you think and what you want to learn about, and I will help you with that.